Hello dear students, this is Vishal sir from Ikra High School. Today we are going to conclude the second part of 9th standard NCERT syllabus chapter 2, part 2, separating the components of a mixture. Now we have understood about the pure material and the mixtures, but how can we separate different components from a mixture? We shall understand this from the different activities given in this section. Let's go through the lesson first. We have learned that most of the natural substances are not chemically pure. Different methods of separations are used to get individual component from a mixture. Separation makes it possible to study and use the individual component of a mixture. Heterogeneous mixtures can be separated into their respective constituent by simple physical method like hand picking, sieving, filtration that we use in our day-to-day life. Sometimes special techniques have to be used for the separation of the components of the mixture. How can we obtain colored component dye from blue or black ink? Let's read the activity. Fill half a beaker with water. You can also look in the diagram. Put a watch glass on the mouth of the beaker. This is the watch glass. Put few drops of ink on the watch glass. Now start heating the beaker. We do not want to heat the ink directly. You will see that evaporation is taking place from the watch glass. So here you can see the water that is boiling in the beaker separates the ink from the water that is mixed in the ink. The water in the ink evaporates due to the heating of this watch glass, and the leftover is the powdered ink, the blue or black ink. Continue heating as the evaporation goes on and stop heating when you do not see any further change on the watch glass. Observe carefully and record your observation. We can find that ink is a mixture of water and dye. Thus, we can separate the volatile component, that is the solvent, here solvent is water, from its non-volatile solute by the method of evaporation. So volatile substances are those substances which evaporate on giving heat to it, and non-volatile substances are those substances which do not evaporate though the heat may be given to it. So if you want to separate the dye from the ink, you have to go through evaporation. Now let's go through another topic, separation of cream from milk. Nowadays we get full cream, toned and double toned variety of milk pack in poly pack or tetra pack in the market. These varieties of milk contain different amounts of fat. Centrifuge heat by using a centrifuging machine for 2 minutes. If a centrifuging machine is not available in the school, you can do this activity at home by using a milk churner used in the kitchen. If you have milk dairy nearby, visit it and ask how they separate milk from milk, how they make cheese from milk. Sometimes the solid particles in a liquid are very small and pass through a filter paper. For such particles, the filtration technique cannot be used for separation. Such mixture are separated by centrifugation. The principle is that the denser particles are forced to the bottom and the lighter particles stay at the top when they spun together. Where is this centrifugation used? It is used in diagnostic laboratories for blood and urine tests, dairies and home to separate butter from milk, and washing machine to squeeze out water from wet clothes. Now, how can we separate a mixture of two immiscible liquids? Immiscible liquid means the liquid that do not mix with each other. Just like oil and water, petrol and water, they do not mix with each other. Those are called immiscible liquids. So, for this immiscible liquid, we need to use an apparatus called separating funnel. To separate kerosene oil and water using a separating funnel, pour the mixture of kerosene oil and water in a separating funnel. Let it stand undisturbed for some time so that the layer separate of oil and water are formed. Here is the stop clock, and that is to be opened very precautiously. Open the stop cup of the separating funnel and pour out the lower layer of the water carefully. So when you open the stop clock over here, the water drains from this, and the leftover, when the kerosene level comes, you have to turn off the stop clock so that kerosene remains here and the water is separated in some another beaker. Close the stop clock of the separating funnel as the oil reaches the stop clock. Application to separate mixture of oil and water in the extraction of iron ore, iron from from its ore. The lighter slag is removed from the top by this method to leave the molten iron at the bottom of the furnace. The iron is separated by heating or the melting of iron, and the iron is heavier, which remains at the bottom part, and the impurities float on the iron that is removed by this method. This principle is that the immiscible liquids separate out in the layer depending in the of their densities. How can we separate a mixture of salt and camphor? We have learned changes directly from solid to gaseous state on heating. To separate such mixtures that contain a sublimable volatile component from a non-sublimable process is used. Here you can see camphor that has been collected in a beaker that is heated, and it is collected in this syringe. The gaseous material is camphor. Some examples of solid which are sublime are ammonium chloride, naphthalene and anthracene. Is the dye in black ink a single color? Let's see through an activity. Take a thin strip of filter paper. Draw a line on it using a pencil, approximately 3 cm above the lower edge. Put a small drop of ink, water soluble, that is from a sketch pen or a fountain pen, at the center of the line. Let it dry. Lower the filter paper into the jar or glass beaker or test tube containing water so that the water of the ink on the paper is just above the water level, as shown in figure 2.8b. Leave it undisturbed. Watch carefully as the water rises up on the filter paper. Record your observations. So, something like this is. This is the method of chromatography, where you separate homogeneous mixtures. Components of dye such as ink may be separated by paper chromatography. Here you can see the color has been separated. The ink that we use has water as the solvent and dye is soluble in it. As the water rises on the filter paper, it takes along with it the dye particles. Usually a dye is a mixture of two or more colors. The colored component that is more soluble in water rises faster, and in this way the color gets separated. This process of separation of component of mixture is known as chromatography. Chroma in Greek means color. This technique was first used for separation of color, so this name was given. Chromatography is a technique used for separation of those solute that dissolve in the same solvent. So if two or more colors are dissolved in the same solvent, that is water, it can be separated by chromatography. With the advancement in technology, newer technique of chromatography have been developed. They are used to separate colors in a dye, pigment from natural colors and drug from blood. How can we separate two miscible liquids? Now, inmiscible liquids were those liquids which were naturally separated, didn't mix with each other. But what about the liquids that are mixed with each other? Let us try to separate acetone and water from their mixture. Take the mixture in a distillation flask. Here you can see an apparatus, and this apparatus is used for distillation. Here two miscible liquids are there, water and acetone. They both mix with each other and cannot be separated easily. You have to use distillation for it. Distillation is a process in which the matter with low melting point evaporates and is collected in another beaker. The matter with high boiling point remains in the same beaker. So this way water and acetone are separated from each other. Heat the mixture slowly, keeping a close watch on the thermometer as the acetone vaporizes, condenses in the condenser. Condenser cools out the hot vapor and again transforms the vapor into liquid. Water is left behind in the distillation flask. It is used for the separation of component of the mixture containing two miscible liquids that boil without decomposition and have sufficient difference in their boiling point. To separate a mixture of two or more miscible liquid for which a difference in boiling point is less than 25, distillation process is used. For example, separation of different gas from air, different fractions from petroleum product, etc. Apparatus is similar to that for simple distillation, except that a fractional column is fitted between the distillation flask and the condenser. Simple fractional column is a tube packed with glass beads. The beads provide surface for the vapor to cool and condense repeatedly, as shown in figure 2.10. How can we obtain different gases from air? Air is a homogeneous mixture and can be separated into its component by fractional distillation. The flow diagram shows the step of the process. The air is compressed and cooled by increasing pressure and decreasing temperature, which becomes liquid air that is allowed to warm up slowly in the fractionating distillation column. And that at that moment, the air gases of the air get separated. Here you can see oxygen, argon and nitrogen are separated.
Air is compressed by increasing the pressure
pressure in as N is then cooled by decreasing the temperature to get liquid air. Liquid air is allowed to warm up slowly in the fractionating column, where gases get separated at different height depending upon their boiling point. How can we obtain pure copper sulfate? Dissolve it in minimum amount of water. Filter the impurities out. Evaporate water from copper sulfate solution so as to get a saturated solution. Cover the solution with a filter paper and leave it undisturbed at a room temperature to cool slowly for a day. The crystals of copper sulfate in a china dish. This process is called crystallization. The crystallization method is used to purify solid. For example, the salt we get from seawater. To remove these impurities, process of crystallization is used. Crystallization is a process that separates a pure solid in the form of its crystal from a solution. Crystallization technique is better than simple evaporation, as some solid decompose or some like sugar may get charred on heating due to dryness. Applications: purification of salt that we get from seawater, separation of crystal of alum from impure samples. Thus, by choosing one of the above method according to the nature of the component of the mixture, we can get pure substances. In cities, drinking water is supplied. The diagram of a typical water work is shown in figure 2.13. Here, you can see water is collected from reservoir. It is collected in the sedimentation tank, where the water is allowed to settle down. Most of the impurities settle down over here. Water is then transferred to loading tank, where the suspended impurities are removed. After that, the water is collected in the filtration tank, where the tank contains fine sand, gravel and coarse gravel, through which the water is passed so that most of the impurities are purified. It is then collected in the chlorination to kill bacteria, which is then reached to our home. Now let's go through the types of pure substances. As you have studied mixture, mixtures are of two types, homogeneous and heterogeneous. Pure substances are also of two types, elements and compound. Elements. Robert Boyle was the first scientist to use the term element in 1661. Anton Laurent Lavoisier, a French chemist, was the first to establish an experimentally useful definition of an element. He defined an element as a basic form of matter that cannot be broken down into simpler substance by chemical reactions. Elements can normally be divided into metal, non-metal and metalloids. So, pure substance is divided into two parts, elements and compounds. Elements can still further be distributed in three parts, metals, non-metals and metalloids. Metal usually show some or all the following property. They have luster, that is shine. They have silvery gray or golden yellow color. They conduct heat and electricity, that means heat and electricity passes through metal elements. They are ductile, means they can be made into wires. They are malleable, that means they can be hammered into sheets. They are sonorous, that means produce sound on striking. Metal examples are gold, silver, copper, iron, sodium, potassium, etc. Mercury is the only metal that is liquid at room temperature. Non-metal usually show some or all of the following property. They display a variety of colors. Poor conductor of heat and electricity. Metal was good conductor of heat and electricity. Non-metals are poor conductor of heat and electricity. They are not lustrous, sonorous or malleable. That means they have the opposite properties of metal. Example of non-metal are hydrogen, oxygen, iodine, carbon, bromine, chlorine, etc. Some elements have intermediate property between those of metal and non-metal. They are metalloids, example boron, silicon and germanium. Another type of pure substances are compounds. Compound is a substance composed of two or more elements chemically combined with one another in a fixed proportion. Example, water. Water is a compound. These are the differences of mixtures and compounds. Mixtures and compounds are totally different. Elements or compounds just mix together to form a mixture and no new compound is formed. So in a mixture, no new substance is formed. while compounds element react to form new compounds. Here you can give an example of water. Water is a compound, and here you can give the lemon juice, that is the mixture of water and lemon. A mixture has variable composition and compound, the composition of each new substance is always fixed. Mixture shows the properties of the constituent substance, that means the water remains as water, while in the compound the new substance has totally different properties. Let's talk about water. Water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen. The constituent can be separated fairly easy by physical method. We have seen all the physical methods separating mixtures: crystallization, sublimation, filtration, sieving, winnowing, etc. But for compounds, the constituent can be separated only by chemical or electrochemical reactions. So for separating the elements from the compound, you need special techniques. But for separating constituents from the mixture, you can have certain specific techniques that separates the components. Here you can see matter is of three types: solid, liquid or gas, and it is separated on the basis of what components are in it as pure substance and mixtures. In pure substance, it is still divided further into elements and compounds, but mixture is separated by their composition, homogeneous and heterogeneous. Thank you.